resurrection, believers met here in Kololo, and they spent 3 days praying, interceding, repenting, and petitioning the Lord for peaceful election and a victorious election.
When you pray before the elections, and God blessed us, now we are, I'm also one of the rappers. We are part of the one rapper who came back to Thali. But I would also like to use this occasion to say, as some of the preachers were saying, yes, we have been fighting for a long time, making our own individual input, but there are many instances where you see this, that this was really God's work, or God's work.
Avoid evil. It seems when you avoid evil, God is happy with that, with what you are doing. Because evil involving stealing money, killing people, doing bad things, because I try my best to avoid evil. Because in the fighting, when we are fighting, we have a lot of power. We have a lot of power to do evil. You can kill people because we have guns. Even when we were fighting, we had guns. Even when we were on the opposition side. But that's why the NRA developed a culture of discipline, because I was always resisting temptations by people who want to take shortcut. I think part of what you call sin, mistakes, is caused by people who want shortcuts. They are essentially lazy. They don't want to be patient, to work for a long time. They think if you take a shortcut, you'll get good results faster. But that shortcut is a danger, because it will make you compromise it. And you will no longer have the cleanliness within you to fight evil.
Heavenly Father, we are gathered here today to bring our praise, worship, and thanksgiving back to you for your great love, for your faithfulness and mercy towards us as a people of Uganda. Psalm 33 verse 12 declares, "Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen as his heritage." Indeed, we can all testify that because you are our God, we are blessed as a people and a nation. Father, let your presence remain with us, and may we find favor in your sight always. Let us always be your people, and may you always be our God. Finally, we pray that it will please you, Lord, to be our chief guest on our inauguration day, that you will take the highest seat of honor on that day. We give you preeminence and all the glory as your people. We invite your presence to come and be enthroned among us, always, so that other nations will now know that we are a people whose God is the Lord. We pray all this in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. And all God's people say, Amen.
Jesus, with thy blessing.